Ralph here, True Power Trumpet Fitness, and welcome to Terrific, Terrific Tuesday here in Connecticut. You saw the thumbnail, okay? Playing on the red. I'm not going to say it's the biggest myth in brass playing, but it is, because there's so many of them. But anyway, we'll get to that. It's so cut and dry, it's ridiculous. So I haven't played much today. I have had a couple students on Skype. I've noodled around with them on the lesson, but I really haven't practiced. So let's see what we got. Feels fine. Double C's and Arban, Carnival of Venice. Cool warm up, huh? Anyway, playing on the red. Tale of two students. One is a former student, and he got my name off the internet. He was local, so he came to the house. Very, very talented young man. And very thick lips and had a very odd teeth structure and everything. So he had a different horn angle and all that sort of thing. And I admit, to take one look at it, it looked like a disaster waiting to happen. I admit, looking at it. And the trumpet teacher changed his mouthpiece to a bathtub, a 1C, to make sure that he covered the lip. Got to the point where he couldn't play. I mean, literally could not play, okay? This was a couple years ago when the 1SS just came out. I said, you know what, try this. He says, well, on the red, I said, don't worry about the red. Don't worry about the red. In a month, he was playing G's above high C. When it finally came out to the 1SB, it was even more. I mean, he was off to the races. Now, he wanted to be a jazz player. And I'm not a jazz player, so he went to another teacher who immediately took him off the mouthpiece. Immediately took him off the mouthpiece, got him back around the red, and he was down to nothing. Haven't heard from him in a long time. I mean, guys, it's a joke. It's a joke. Those pictures that you saw as I was coming. That was Herseth, Adolf Herseth. Was he playing on the red? You bet. You bet. And he is one of the greatest players that ever lived. And that was with a Bach mouthpiece. He was playing on the red. Guys, it doesn't matter. What is going on that is crucial to your playing is inside your mouth. You are spit buzzing and putting a megaphone on it. It doesn't matter if it's on the red or not. It does not matter. And to take a kid that is playing quite well, and just because it doesn't look right, completely ruin his playing, is ridiculous. Okay? Now, there are tons of players that play on the red. Great ones that play on the red. Look, I don't happen to have a lot of flesh. Okay, so it's very easy for me not to play in the red. Okay, and definitely nobody can argue at all that playing on the red on the bottom is any playing. I think I might be on the red on the bottom. It doesn't matter. Now, these pictures that you saw are from Philip Farkas' Art of Brass Playing, which is the biggest pile of gobbledygook you'll ever read. Don't bother. But these are the pictures. And there's also a picture cataract. I mean, guys, it doesn't matter. Now, I've got another student. He was one of the guys I had this morning. Okay. Very, very talented Latin soloist. Did a lot of Latin work and everything. His chops were nothing when he came to me. Nothing when he came to me. Now, for the longest time, now he's, I don't even know, I'd say in his mid-30s maybe. For the longest time, and he's played for a while, Latin type stuff. For the longest time, he played quite naturally. His high note was maybe a C or a D above high C. High C or D, okay? And he wanted to get more, so he started looking around the internet. And I don't know if a teacher told him to do it or if he just surmised that he was supposed to. But he was playing on the red, and he tried to move it up so he was not playing on the red, and he got thrown for a loop. Could barely play a note when he came to me. Okay? And he is transfixed with whether or not he's supposed to. I said, get rid of it. Don't even think about it. Don't even think about it. Okay? And after three lessons, he's gone from literally nothing to a good solid G and A flat above the staff, okay? And the high C is going to be back in no time. He started off, he was playing a Warburton something, which is quite a big mouthpiece. And he started with the 1SS. Had a little more depth to it to simulate the Warburton. He sounds better to me on the 1SB. So he's going to go with a 1SB exclusively this week, I guarantee you. Today's Tuesday. I will see you next Tuesday. I guarantee you he'll be killing double C's. And not double C's, high C's. Guarantee you. And the double C will come soon after. His spit buzzing is spot on. But he got thrown completely because he was supposed to not be playing on the red. It means nothing. Play on the red, the blue, the green, whatever you want to play on. Just make sure the compression is proper inside your mouth, okay? Make sure you have a callet mouthpiece to make the megaphone, the projection correct. And you can play on, you can, my man Mel Broyles, you know, he was a diehard Vacchiano student, one of Proje, he loves William. And he, at the time, I was fooling around with Jerry's mouthpieces. And of course, Vacchiano thought they were the root of all evil. Okay? I brought him out and I played for Mel. He says, gee, sounds great. And I said, you know, this is a callet mouthpiece. You want me playing that? He says, Ace, you can stick it up your ass and fart for all I care as long as it sounds good. Guys, the sound will tell you if it's right. The sound, and it doesn't matter if it's on the red, the green, the orange, the pink, whatever. The whole work is done inside the mouth. And the rest is for vibration. Got it? Don't sweat playing on the red. Anyway, eat and drink fruits and vegetables, and I will see you tomorrow for the great Gatala. 1, 2, 3.